Now for the next few videos, I'm going to show you an actual coded up example of PCA as applied to facial recognition. This is taken and adapted from an example on the sklearn documentation, so I'll include a link to the original code so you can go in and take a look at it. But I want to walk you through some of the most important parts. So the first thing that the code does is import a set of pictures of famous world leaders from about 10 to 15 years ago. The next thing that it does is it splits it into a training and testing set. Very good. But then this block right here is where the PCA actually happens. You'll see in this example, and sometimes in the literature, that PCA is also called eigenfaces when it's applied to facial recognition. So in this line here, we actually see the PCA being created. It's called randomized PCA in sklearn. And then it's also being fit to the training data. Then what this line does here is it asks for the eigenfaces. The eigenfaces are basically the principal components of the face data. So it takes the PCA components, and then it reshapes them, because right now they're just strings of numbers, and it wants to turn those back into squares so that they look like pictures. You can also see that the number of principal components that are being used in this example is 150. And if you look at the example code on the sklearn documentation page, you'll see that the original dimensionality of these pictures is over 1,800. So we've gone from 1,800 features down to 150, a compression factor of more than 10. Then the last thing that I do with PCA is I transform my data. When I perform the fit command, I'm just figuring out what the principal components are. It's these transform commands where I actually take my data and transform them into the principal components representation. Then the rest of this code is creating an SVM. Remember that SVC is what it's called in sklearn, a support vector classifier. They do a little bit of fancy footwork here to figure out exactly what parameters of the support vector machine they want to use. And then using the principal components as the features, they try to identify in the test set who appears in a given picture. Now I'll show you what this looks like when I run this code. First thing that it does is it prints out a doc string, just tells me what's going on, and then some information about the data set. So I have 1,288 samples with 1,850 features available to me in the input feature space. 7 different people are appearing, and then we use 150 eigenfaces from the 966 faces in our training set. The next thing that appears is a list of the people in our data set and how often we get them correct. Precision, recall, F1 score, and support are things that are sort of related to the accuracy. They're evaluation metrics. We'll talk a lot about those in a coming lesson. You can see that in general, though, it's getting things correct roughly 60 to almost 90% of the time. So even though we've reduced our dimensionality by a factor of 10, we're still having really good performance. And then the thing that's really cool that I love about this example is they actually show you the eigenfaces. So this is the first principal component of our data. This is the second principal component, the third one. So this image here represents the maximal variation that it sees across all the data. It's a little bit hard to understand exactly what that means in this example. It would be better if it said something like how far apart the eyes are or whether the person wears glasses or not. Instead, what we get are these kind of ghost images. But then using these composite images together as features in an SVM, it can be very powerful in predicting whose face we see. And then last but not least, there's a little printout that gives you 12 representative faces and the algorithm's best guess about who it is and the actual answer. So you can see it doesn't always get them correct. This one right here, it thinks it's Tony Blair, but it's actually George W. Bush. But on most of them, it's getting it correct. Pretty cool.